harem of hens. Anyone have a hen harem? I don't know. That's one of my roosters. I like that guy. And then after that, we got another trade set up right into the golden pocket with bullish divergence. We can see here on the 3 minute. That was a nicer trade. We got a super nice chickens drinking water bounce right out of the golden pocket right there. Look at that. These are those nice chicken drinking water type bounces. That trade, 21% profits. That was pretty nice. And I was hoping for this setup right here, coming down to the 382 level. I'm going to talk about that more. But we didn't get that. We only came down to a different golden pocket that it was a higher golden pocket that we got the bounce out of. So those were the trades I took yesterday. I'm currently long, currently short on Bitcoin, only long on Ethereum. So what am I kind of looking for now? Well, we have to take into account the fact that this is a weekend upon us, guys. There is a weekend upon us. Sorry for the lack of Jason Casper glasses here. And weekends are known for their erratic moves. Now, historically, I'm talking about the ancient past, and you know in crypto, every month is the equivalent to a year, right? Right? It seems like so long ago that we were down in the 20,000s, but now we're up in the 40,000s, and sorry for the water, guys. It's hot out this morning. I was out there doing some hard farmer work, and I usually don't drink from these plastic bottles, right? I know that there's harmful chemicals in there, but it was on hand and it's what I had. So, lest anyone judge me for the plastic, I usually drink from glass. Okay. Weekends are known for the erratic movements. Usually, you know, up until maybe a few months ago, weekends were known for their dumps. But recently, weekends have had pumps, right? Let's take a look at the past few weekends here for the Bitcoin. If we go to the 4-hour time frame, we can see that last time we had a week end, which was when the 10th, I think, the 8th was a Sunday. You know what? I don't even remember. 7 days ago was the 10th. So was that a Friday? I don't remember. Yeah. I don't remember, actually. But I do know that we've been pumping on the weekends. And if we go to the weekly time frame for Bitcoin, we can see that we still have upward potential here. We still have upward potential. The happy wappy is still pretty upright. The money flow is still thickening, right? And we are printing this nice little green dot. Just 2 weeks ago, we confirmed that green dot, and we know historically that green dots do give us moves to the upside, even if we're in a downtrend. Those green dots give us a move to the upside on the weekly time frame, right? Like this one right here, you know, even though it was we were in the middle of a downtrend, while that weekly dot was printing right here, we still did get, you know, a 40% move to the upside there before another dump. And then, of course, this green dot right here was this one right here. This one gave us a nice, let's see. I'm going to give us a nice 60% move to the upside. So even though we were in a downtrend here, these green dots were giving us some nice moves to the upside. So, you know, that's just something to keep in mind. So far with this weekly green dot, we have gotten about 60% move to the upside. So it's very possible, guys, that if we are indeed in a downtrend, and this is the high of the bull market, and we've entered into what I like to call, I don't like to use the term bear market, right? I don't like that term. It's politically incorrect. I prefer to use healthy correction, right? Healthy correction. My generation, we don't like to be offended, right? We don't like to hear things that make us uncomfortable or make us sad, or, you know, life has to be perfect for us. So I call it a healthy correction. You know, it's basically, when I call it that, it makes me feel like, you know, I'm getting my participation trophy for having traded Bitcoin at all, right? You know, good job, Jason. You know, you get your participation trophy. Here's your healthy correction. So if this is a healthy correction, you know, it's just the lower high, and then we will come down lower, okay? So the question is right now, on the daily time frame, we're putting in a red dot, but look at this, right? Look at this. We can see that the VWAP is indeed putting in higher lows. And we can see that momentum is indeed putting in higher highs. We can see also that the VWAP on the daily is about to curve to the upside once again. Once again, it's about to curve to the upside. That to me makes me think that we potentially could just continue on with the uptrend until we get to higher levels and we are just in need of cooling off or a slight consolidation. Right now, well, let's take a look at this. The first leg up, we came up, right? We got a nice rejection off of what was actually a 382 fib level. We came down and got a nice bounce off a 382 fib level. Perhaps we're about to do something similar on this second leg up where we come up, and who knows where we're going to come to. Maybe this is the top, maybe not. Maybe we come up a little bit higher. 48K or something like that would be pretty nice, maybe to the weekly. And then we would come down. If we get one last pump up here, we could come down, bounce off the 382, and continue up from there. So there's room for upside on the daily, on the weekly. But once we start going down to the 4-hour, now things are starting to look pretty bearish, are they not? Because we have this going on here, where ever since really we started this this move from the ups from the downside, the low of the range down here at 29K, give or take, price has been putting in the higher highs, and momentum has been putting in lower highs ever since that point. We also can see here that money flow has been coming down on the 4-hour. We're connecting the highs of the money flow waves. A lot of people don't know, but you know, if you connect the highs and lows of the money flow waves, you can get an idea of where the market is heading. Check this out. If we connect the high of this purple wave, alright y'all, the goal of this course is to equip you with the knowledge and the skills that you need to become a confident, profitable trader. And I want to welcome you and I want to congratulate you on taking those first steps on actually learning how to do this the right way so that you don't waste time and so that you don't waste money. Now, I am confident that once you go through these sessions, you will have a firm grasp on some of the most fundamental things that you need to know in order to trade in a way which will make you money over time. The goal here is not to make money quick. The goal here is not to get rich quick overnight. The goal here is to develop a skill set, which you will constantly and consistently be able to build upon for the rest of your career as a trader. Now, first of all, I am flopping and groping a little bit here because I couldn't find my PDF, but now that I can find it, let's go through just an introduction, all right? Let me let you guys know what you've just gotten yourselves into. Now, when this course is over, I am confident that all of you will be able to fully grasp and understand how to become a confident, profitable trader. But here's the thing. And this is the reality of the situation. Learning how to trade is the easy part of this. You can do it, absolutely, as long as you put in the time and the work. What's not easy is actually developing a strategy, sticking to that strategy, having the discipline and the patience to actually trade the way you know you should. You will find, and we'll get into this later in the course, that the psychology of trading will be your number one roadblock. So first in this course, we're going to go over the technicals, right? Technical analysis, how to mark levels, how to use Market Cipher, et cetera, et cetera. But then we're going to get more into the psychological aspects of it. So what separates a winning trader from a losing trader? It's their psychological mindset, okay? This will absolutely make or break you. Your psychological mindset will make or break you as a trader. Good traders need to be comfortable taking risks. Now, I'm not talking about gambling here. I'm talking about calculated risks where they're weighing the probabilities and taking risks, understanding, yes, I might lose something here, but the potential for gain is huge. You need to be comfortable doing that. Some traders, some people who go start trading, they don't ever risk enough capital to make any significant money. Second thing, you need to be able to adjust to a changing market. Now, this is really important because we just, you know, for me here, I don't know when you're watching this, but we just had a massive move to the upside, right? From about October 2020 all the way to April 2020, we had a massive move to the upside. Then we had a massive move to the downside. And now the market has been trending sideways for the past, you know, 2 weeks or so. And so it's very important that you can adjust to a changing market. You need to know how to trade in a bull market, how to trade in a bear market, how to trade in a sideways ranging market. And you can't get stuck in the mindset of only looking to trade as if we're in a bull market if we're no longer in a bull market, as if we're in a sideways market if we're no longer in a sideways market. You need to be able to adapt. You need to be disciplined in your trading style, and you need to be able to view the market objectively with no bias. This is difficult. It's difficult, especially for people who always want the Bitcoin price to go up and are always looking for, you know, those longs, right? Always looking for those longs, always buying the dip. Buy the dip, man. Buy the dip. Buy the dip, right? Well, you buy this dip, what happens? You know? So you have to just be able to adapt your mindset and look at the markets objectively. We'll get into it later, but clearly when these moving averages cross, we know we're now in a downtrend, and we need to be able to adjust and change with that. Right? I'm sorry that I don't have my windows going on here. Traders don't get overexcited about winning, and they also don't, and this is actually extremely important. Winning traders don't get upset over losses. You have to understand that losses are just a part of trading. Losses will absolutely come. Okay, I yesterday took five trades. I took five trades. Okay. One of them got stopped out, and that's just part of trading. That's just part of trading. In hindsight, I can go and see what I did wrong, but that is just part of trading. You can't let your emotions get in the way. If you win a huge trade, you can't feel like now I'm the champion and I'm the best and I'm just awesome at trading. And if you lose, you can't feel like, oh, I'm the worst. I suck at trading. You have to understand, and this is extremely important, risk management. And we're going to get into this later in the course. But you have to understand how to manage your money and how to manage your risk in a way that will allow and take for granted the fact that losses will happen, while also making it happen in a way where you will be profitable over time. Okay? Well, you will be profitable over time. Before you start trading, this is also important. You need to decide what type of trader you want to be, and this will depend heavily on your lifestyle and your responsibilities. The material that we're going to cover in the course will apply to all of these trading styles. Let me quickly go over what they are. Scalping. Scalping is all about making very quick trades. The goal is to make constant profits on lower time frames. Okay? Let me show you an example of a scalp trade. Now, this Discord that I'm showing you right here is this Discord is no longer available, okay? In fact, while I have you here, and we're talking about this, and I'm switching windows and flopping and groping, let me just tell you, first of all, none of this is financial advice, okay? This is for educational purposes only, and the information that I'm going to provide in this course is my own personal experience that I have gathered over the years. This is exactly what I wish I had known before I started trading. And this is by no means meant to be taken as financial advice. You should not. I am not a financial advisor, you know. I highly recommend if you have never traded before, you start trading either paper trading or risking a very small amount of money, and only do it after you go through the entire course. And again, this is not financial advice. If you are looking for financial advice, you need to go find yourself a financial advisor, okay? The course on this website, just so everybody is aware, does not come with any Discord access besides access to the Jason Casper free Discord, which is here, okay? The free Discord, there's a lot of great traders in here doing a lot of great TA. You can join this Discord for free. And then there's also a VIP Discord. The VIP Discord is where we have a private Discord here for people who are Patreons. And also, this is where I post. If you ever see me on YouTube posting my potential trade setups, I post them in this Discord here. In order to get to this Discord, you have to go to patreon.com/JasonCasper. And then you will get to the VIP section where I do weekly technical analysis updates. I'm always posting technical analysis, little updates, showing you updates, where I'm looking to trade. I do a weekly video where I go over my plan every week on swing trades that I'm looking for. I will post potential trade setups in here as well. And the reason I'm even talking about this in the first place is because I was talking about scalping, which is about making very quick trades. The goal is to make consistent profits on lower time frames. In order to be a scalper, you need to be able to look at the charts all day, every day, and capitalize on these really small moves. An example of a scalp trade that I took is this trade right here. This trade, you can see we came up to the resistance. We got a quick rejection off of it. Immediately, I entered the trade at 37,603. We dropped down. I closed the trade at 37,493. Okay? A very small move. A very small move. And in order to catch small moves like this, you will need to be able to look at the charts all day. Okay? A little tiny scalp. And over time, these will add up. These will add up for your profit, right? The next type of trader, what's going on here, guys? The next type of trader is a day trader, okay? Intraday trader, day trader. Basically, this is kind of like scalping, but instead of making moves over the course of literally minutes, you can be in the trade for maybe a few hours, maybe even a few days. And an example of this is a trade that I took last night, where it started out as a scalp. I said, I'm going to scalp this little move. And I just kept on letting it ride, taking profits along the way down. And I'm currently still in this trade, right? Because we hit our take profit, we hit our second take profit, we hit our third take profit. And so now I still have, 40%. In the trade, and I'm just letting it ride. You're gonna see how far I can take it, and I'm still currently in this trade, and it's currently up about 207%. And then there's intraday trading. Okay, intraday trading. This is like day trading, but you can hold positions for maybe multiple days. Okay, maybe even a week you can be in a trade, right? Maybe even a week. And then there's swing trading. Swing trading is all about finding support and trading to the next resistance level, or more generally, picking an entry and a target and holding the position until your target is hit or other exit conditions are met. Now, a great example of this is a trade that I'm actually currently in right now, an Ethereum trade that's up 665%. It's a swing trade. I entered the trade when Ethereum was very high, close to the all-time high. And I'm still currently in that trade. I'm still currently in that trade. The reason I'm still in that trade Well, this might be technical if you're completely new, but I'll tell you anyway. The reason I'm still in that trade is because, let me get to a clean Ethereum chart for us here, guys. The reason I am still in that trade is because on the higher time frames, like the daily time frame, we are still technically printing lower lows and lower highs until we come up above this level right here. I will keep that trade open. I've taken out a lot of profit already. We'll get into that later on how to manage an open trade, how to take out profit, how to lock. In profit, we will get into that later. Basically, these styles of trading, scalping is the most time intensive. You will literally need to do that full time and look at the chart every single day and make many small trades. Day trading, intraday trading. You will need to keep the charts open. You will need to have alerts set on your phone when you want to enter. We'll get into that later too. But you might only make, one trade a day, maybe one, two trades a day. Sometimes you won't make a trade for a few days, okay? You can do both. You can scalp and enter little tiny trades while you're looking for a nice intraday trade setup. Now, for swing trades, these will only come up very, very rarely, okay? Very rarely. Swing trades, because we're looking to capitalize on large moves. So if we go to our Bitcoin chart here, and let me put on a cleaner chart for us, guys. If we go to our Bitcoin chart, good old Bitcoin, and we zoom out to the weekly time frame, what opportunities would you have had to really enter a swing trade here? Well, for a swing long, you could have entered one here. And honestly, you could have held this thing all the way up to the top, right? You could have really entered one right here as well after the summer. You could have entered one right here, could have entered one right here, and just rode it on up. And if you don't understand what this chart is, we're going to get into that too. We're going to get into everything that you see here, TradingView, how to use it. But these don't come up too often, right? Another swing trade you could have entered was one right here. In fact, believe it or not, I did enter a swing trade right here at about 59K, right here. And I rode that thing literally down here, okay? Literally rode it down there. I didn't close the trade here, right? I closed the trade somewhere in here, okay? And believe it or not, now I'm currently in a swing long trade. And if you follow me on the YouTubes, you know about that trade. If you're already in my Discord, you know about that trade. I've been long from 32K on Bitcoin, and I'm just holding this thing, expecting that we're going to come up. So if you're watching this at a later date, you'll know if I'm in profit or not, right? If we have a little whoopsie daisy, then you'll know that I got wrecked. But if we continue up, then you'll know that it was a successful swing trade. The reason I'm talking about all this is because this will determine what your focus is going to be and what time frames you are trading on, okay? Then there's position trading. Literally, this is just hodling, okay? So like I bought Bitcoin in 2016, I'm still hodling it, I'm in profit. Let's talk about some expectations, okay? Trading is definitely not a get rich quick scheme. If you try to get rich quick, you will go broke quick, even if you start out winning money. I know so many people during this bull run that just bought the dip, bought the dip, bought the dip, market cipher. They longed the green dot, longed the green dot, longed the green dot. Now that we've had a correction, and now that we've been literally trading sideways, and people say, "Oh, we're coming back up. Let me buy in here because we're coming back up." And then zoop, we come back down, and they're like, "Dang, I better sell and get out." And then the price comes up. They're like, "Oh, let me buy." And then the price comes back down, and they're like, "Dang, I'm in a loss." And then the price comes up. They're like, "Oh, maybe there's hope." Nope, just kidding. No hope. So, it's if you start out making money, either you're getting lucky or if there's a bull market, if you have this attitude of, "I am going to turn my $1,000 account into a $1 million account." Is it possible? Absolutely, it's possible. But the truth is, guys, if your focus is on making money fast, I guarantee you will lose your money fast. Desperation is the thief of gains. I'm telling you, if you are desperate to make money, you need to go do something else, okay? The markets will absolutely humble you. They will take away tens, hundreds of thousands of dollars from you in minutes, okay? You need to take your time and study hard and practice good risk management and focus, instead of making money, focus on the skill of trading. Focus on learning the skills that you will need to make to have longevity in this career, right? If you want to make this your career, you absolutely can. You absolutely can, and there's so much money to be made here. But the focus should never be on the making of the money. The focus should be on learning the skill. Because here's the thing, if you have the skill, then the money becomes irrelevant. The money really does become irrelevant. If you have the skill of trading, the money becomes irrelevant. Yes, the more capital you have, the more money you can make. But if you get good at this, you will absolutely be able to take a small amount of money and turn it into a larger amount of money. And then the more capital you get, there's just a snowball effect where you'll be able to make more and more, right? It compounds. But this is going to take hard work and dedication, okay? Again, if you have a small account, it's going to take some time before you're able to trade full time. Focus on honing your skills and gaining experience. Remember, preservation of capital should be your number one priority. The gains will come naturally if you focus on not losing money. Number one step to making money, who said this? I'm pretty sure it was a guy named Warren Buffet, or Warren Buffett. However you want to say his name, Warren Buffet, Warren Buffett, I don't know. Number one step of making money is not losing money. Very important. If your focus is on keeping the money in your trading account there, the gains will naturally come. Now, you also need to have a strategy, and you will learn that in this course. I'm going to teach you multiple strategies that you can use at all different skill levels for different market conditions. And I'm going to teach you strategies that work, okay? I've taken a lot of trading courses, and they always say, I'm not going to show you my strategy. I want you to create your own strategy. Well, for me, I don't like that because I'm a musician, right? And what if somebody just handed me a guitar and said, oh, I'm not going to teach you how to play any songs. No. I want you to write your own songs by yourself. Well, that's not good. You need to learn other people's songs. You need to get influenced. You need to have inspiration. You need to have a starting point. So I'm going to show you strategies that work. You will have a very firm foundation and starting point. And then you will eventually be able to create your own strategy, right? You'll probably start with the things I teach you. You'll tweak it. You'll learn more. You'll progress in your technical analysis. You'll go far beyond the things I'm going to show you here. But once you have this strategy, you need to stick to it. And not only stick to it, but execute without emotion, right? You need to robotically trade. Emotions will only get in the way of your success. Let me show you what I mean. Case in point. Yesterday, I entered three short trades, okay? Three shorts. Let's take a look. Let's take a look at the three shorts I entered. One, right here. Boom, boom, boom. Two take profits. Second one, right here. Zhoop, stopped out. Third one, right here. Boom, 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 boom. Hit or take profit. I forget what happened after this, okay? And then I took more shorts. One of them I'm actually still in, which I showed you right here. It's up 200%. But here's the thing. This trade, this middle one I got stopped out, I did not trade like a robot. You know why? I didn't stick to my strategy. I didn't stick to my strategy. My strategy is wait for the price to come above the line and then enter short when we drop below the line. Well, guess what? Guess what I did? I didn't wait for price to come above the line. I just saw that we spiked up, came down, printed a lower high, and I said, you know what? I'm going to short this. Got stopped out, okay, in a loss. I should have waited for my strategy because here's the thing. If I had stuck to my strategy, I wouldn't have entered this at all. I would have entered this trade and then I would have been in more profit. So it's important that when you have your strategy, you stick to it. Okay, here are some things that you need for this course. First of all, TradingView. The free version will work, but I recommend you get the paid version. Secondly, Market Cipher, the indicator Market Cipher. This is my preferred trading indicator. Now, do you need Market Cipher to trade? No. Can you use other indicators? Yes. People use other indicators. For me, I really enjoy Market Cipher. I have used many trading indicators over the years, and this one by far does. It will give you, how do I say this?
It's just such a reliable indicator. It basically takes every good thing about every other indicator, plus some secret sauce, and puts it all into one. Okay? Market Cipher B is such a powerful indicator. Let me turn on good old Market Cipher B here. Good old Market Cipher B. Where's that? Where's Mark? Aha! Market Cipher B. This thing, if I didn't have Market Cipher B, I would probably lose like 25% of my trades. I'm not even kidding. Maybe even 30 more. More. Because this tells you when to enter. It tells you what direction the price is going. It literally tells you money coming in and going out of Bitcoin. Literally. I mean, no other indicator can do this, right? I've seen people get wrecked because they're just using the regular RSI or the regular old MACD. This thing is literally telling you if money is coming in or coming out of Bitcoin or any other asset you're trading, right? And another thing, guys, this course obviously is focused around Bitcoin, but you can apply these principles to the Forex market, to the stock market. It's all the same thing. It's the same thing. All right? Sorry for waxing southern on you guys. TradingView, Market Cipher. Again, not required, but highly recommended. I'm going to spend a lot of time using Market Cipher, but if you don't have it, I will spend some time talking about how to use other indicators, which definitely do not work as well. Trading account on an exchange. I'm talking about Bybit. I'm talking about Femex. I'm talking about Binance. I'm talking about KuCoin. I'm talking about, I don't know, whatever exchange you want. You need to have a desire to learn and a desire to put in the work. Back testing, spending hours at the charts, losing sleep over it, losing your relationships. Just kidding. Okay. Not that far, guys. But seriously, you need to put in work. So let's talk about how to use and customize TradingView. So you probably, if you're totally new to trading, you see people using these charts and you're like, "What in the world are these charts? How do I even understand these charts?" Well, what you're going to do is you're going to go to tradingview.com and you're going to sign up for an account. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you how to customize and use TradingView. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a new layout, a brand new layout here, and I'm going to go ahead and turn off this volume indicator as well. And let me see, color theme. We'll do it light because when you first open up TradingView, it's going to look like this. Okay, it's going to look like this, and most people prefer to use the dark theme, okay? Most people prefer to use the dark theme, but this is the light theme. So, let's start out with charts. What is a chart? Well, this is a chart, and on the chart is something called price action. Price action is the price moving up, moving down, moving up, and moving down. Volatility within the market is called price action. And on this chart, you'll see many things. Over to the right, you'll see the price of the asset. Okay, you'll see the history. You can scroll back in time. Over on the left, you have many different tools that you can select to use, and we'll get into many of these here. Up here, we have the different time frames. Now, when you first open up your TradingView, you are going to have only a drop-down menu that will allow you to put a time frame on. Okay, if you star one of them, right, it will add it in a quick button up here that you can push very easily. I recommend starring the ones that you like to use. If you want to create a custom time frame, you're going to scroll down to the bottom. And let's say I want to do a 13-minute time frame. I'm going to do 13 minutes and I'll add that. Now I should be able to come up and have a 13-minute time frame right here. I can put that on. Now each candle, which we'll get into what a candle is in a second, is now 13 minutes. Okay. Now we need to talk about watch lists. Okay, you're going to find, especially if you're trading multiple cryptocurrencies, that you want to switch between charts very quickly. Now, you can come up here and type in whatever asset you want, like ETH, USD. Quick note here, guys, it's important to select the exchange that you are using, right? If you're trading on Bybit, make sure to select the one that's on Bybit and not the one on Kraken, not the one on Bitfinex, because this will be in sync with your exchange. And if it's not in sync with your exchange, then it's not going to be the best, okay? So let's say you're trading Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP, Litecoin, and every time you want to switch real quick in between charts, now you have to come up here and you have to type LTC, USDT, and on Binance, and then you want to go back to Bitcoin real quick, and you're like, oh, BTC. You don't want to have to deal with that. What you want to be able to do is create a watch list. Over here, okay, you're going to be able to create a watch list. Click this button, and what you're going to do is you are going to create a new list. And let's call it, what should we call it? We should call it watch list. Very creative, I know. Now, once you've created this watch list, you can click this plus button, and now you can do BTC, USD, and just add that to your list. Now you can do ETH, USD, and just add that to your list. Or if you're trading the Ethereum Bitcoin pair, you can add that to your list. And now you can quickly go back and forth between charts, real easy, okay? It's pretty nice, right? Just going back and forth between the charts. You don't have to type in everything, and what in the world is going on with this? I don't know, okay? I don't know. But that's how you're going to make a watch list. Very important. Something else that's very important is the alerts section. The alerts section, this is where you will be able to create an alert that will send a message to your phone if something happens that means it's time to get into a trade. Very important. Very, very important. We'll get into that more later. But the way in general you set an alert is you can right-click on something or click this Create Alert button, and you can set your conditions. Ethereum USD is crossing up over the value of, let's say, $26.72, okay, and we want to get an alert every time that happens, and then we click, we can give it a name, like alert, explanation point, alert, explanation point, create that alert. Now what happens is every time the Bitcoin, the Ethereum price crosses this level, we'll get an alert, okay, and it's also important to know that if you click notify on app, this will send it to the app on your smartphone so that you could be anywhere, outside in the garden, plowing the field, feeding the chickens, taking care of the goats, and you'll know it's time to enter a trade. Better take my chicken poop covered, goat milk covered, dirt covered hands over to the laptop in the bed of the pickup truck, because it's time for me to enter a trade, all right? Now, sorry guys, again, waxing southern. Okay, gonna end that. Let's see what else we got to go over here. Colors. Let's talk about colors. Colors. If you know anything about Jason Casper, you know that I love my colors. Okay, look at how beautiful and luscious this chart is, right? Compared to. Hang on. Let me turn these off so we can compare. How beautiful and luscious this chart is compared to this chart. Ugh. Green and red and white. This is not Christmas, okay? Blue and purple and black. That's what I like. And the good thing about TradingView is you can do anything you want. Simply right-click right here. And then color theme. This will help you do dark or light. You can create a custom theme, okay? And load it. And you could even change, right? Like, for example, all green candles, okay? Or example, this layout, red and blue. Or this layout, purple and blue. Ah, that's what I like, my favorite. Okay, this, believe it or not, red and blue on a white background is what I used to use to trade Forex. But when I'm trading crypto, I need to get a little cooler with it, okay? I actually like this with the black border of the candles. It looks really clean and crisp to me. But basically, the first thing you're going to do is select if you want the light or the dark, okay? I prefer the dark. And then what you can do is right-click and go to settings, okay? Here's where you can change everything. You can change the candle body color, okay? We can make Instead of green, we could do gold. Okay, we could do gold. And instead of red, we could do silver. Okay, we'll do gold and silver. And then the borders of the candles too. We could make them all white if we wanted to make the borders just pure white, for example. Or let's do, for the gold candles, we can do a nice bright yellow border. And for the silver candles, we can do a nice dark gray border. And we could even change the wick color too, right? So I could make my wicks that same gold color. And then I will make my silver candles have a nice silver color wick. Okay, you can do anything you want with these. You know, we can make them pink. Let's do this pink. Pink. Pink, pink, and purple. Purple, purple, purple. We can change the background of our chart in general, right? If we come down to appearance, right, we can make the background. We want it to be a gradient. We can make it orange and red. Orange and red, or let's make it orange and green, okay? So we have pink and purple candles with an orange and green gradient. We can change the color of the grid lines that we have on here. We can make them black and make them very opaque, like this. We can make these grid lines. Let's make them green here. And we can adjust the opacity of the lines. We can make them dashed instead of solid, right? Like this. And we could put a watermark in the back that tells us what the chart is, right? Ethereum, USD, you've seen some charts looking like this. People put the watermark here. We can make the watermark, let's make the watermark like this light blue color, and we'll make it extremely opaque, right? There you go. There's a whole bunch of different things in here, okay? Really, the only thing that you need to know is the symbol and then the appearance. And I know what you're thinking, okay? Oh, and also, if you want to save this so that you can get it back, you can save it as beautiful layout. Beautiful layout, and go ahead and click save. I don't want to save this. This is a once, this is just a, what do they call it? Where there's only one of a kind. One of a kind beautiful art. And like I was saying, I know what you're thinking. How am I not making billions of dollars as an artist? I don't know. I don't know. I keep writing the people, and they're not paying me for my art. So you know the people I'm talking about. You know what people I'm talking about? So that's how you're gonna customize your trading view. Now let's talk about indicators. Indicators are very important. Indicators are up here where it says indicators and strategies. You're going to go ahead and click that, and you can search for indicators. Like, let's just RSI. RSI, one of the most popular indicators, the relative strength index. When you see these indicators here, if you want them to go into your favorites, you're going to go ahead and click the star. In fact, you'll see me saying this a lot. The star will make things easier for you. So if you like to use the RSI, always click the star, and then it'll come under your favorites, okay? For me, I have Market Cipher B in here, but any indicator you want, the RSI, volume, we're going to get into all that stuff later. You will find that under indicators. You can search. There's a lot of free indicators. There's also some paid indicators in here. Moving averages, you will find those in here. The EMA ribbon, right? The famous EMA ribbon. We will find that in there as well, okay? And for indicators, once you have them open, you will see that there's information in the upper left corner here. You can customize those indicators by clicking the gear button. You'll be able to change the colors. You'll be able to change the inputs, like the length of the RSI. What do we want that to be? You know, stock, it comes 14, but you can change it. The time frame of the RSI. Same for the EMA ribbon, right? You can change things in here by clicking the gear button. Coming up to the indicator and clicking the gear button. If you want to remove the indicator, you simply click this X. If you want to turn it off, where you still want it there, but you want to turn it off, you're going to click the eyeball button. Okay, click that eyeball. And same goes for the RSI, right? We could turn that off, and then we could close it, and we could close it. Now let's talk about the tools on the left-hand side. Okay, the tools on the left-hand side, it's very important that we understand how to use these things and where they are. Okay, so right here, this will change, you know, what we see as our main cursor. Do you want a dot? Do you want a crosshair? Do you want an arrow? Right? And these do some different things. I like to keep this on cross. Then here we have all different trend lines, horizontal rays. If there's a shortcut, you will be able to see that here. If you star these things, they will show up in a little moving toolbar right here that's always on your screen so that I can click instead of, if I don't want to come here and click trend line, I can just click the trend line right here. And then I can use a trend line. This is a nice yellow trend line. Okay. I recommend starring the things you want to use, right? Our fib. We want to use our fib. It's already starred. I could just pull it out. We'll get more into fibs later. People know I love to use the fib. They call me Fibmaster J. Okay. You're going to find every tool you need right here. This is a measuring stick, so you can measure percentages of past moves or potential future moves. You can also measure the amount of time, right? If I drag it to the side, it will give me information. We went 0.5% and it took 1 day, 7 hours, and 22 minutes. You see that? This is your brush tool where you'll be able to draw happy pictures on the chart, okay, like that. And there's other things in here too, like a highlighter where you can highlight certain things if you want to show somebody something. You can do a rectangle if you want to mark out a certain buy zone, let's say, of support and resistance. There's text if you want to write. There's long and short positions right here where you could just back testing, say if I had entered long right here and I set my stop loss right here and I set my take profit up here, what would my trade be and how much would I have made and how much time? If you're looking to, you know, enter a potential trade, you can do that. And then, of course, we have a smiley face. Who wouldn't want a smiley face on their chart? This right here, this magnifying glass, is very important. A lot of people, they like zoom in by trying to like use their mouse and like use these things and try and find a certain area. If you just use your magnifying glass, if you want to just look at this area, just drag it and boom, you have that area. If you want to reset your screen back to the small size, you can just click this refresh arrow right here. Okay, if you want to use replay mode to go back in time and back test, you can click this up here, replay mode, and click where you want it to go to. You can see that it will make it as if you're looking at the chart at that time, and then you have this little play button here, and you can say, okay, I was going to short up there. I was going to short here, and I would have put my stop loss up here, and we'll get into all this later, what stop losses and all that are. But then you can replay it and see, would I have won the trade or would I have lost the trade? Would I have won or lost the trade? Well, it looks like you would have won that trade. Looks like you probably would have taken some nice profits out of that. Okay? If you want to, I'm sure you've seen people post, if you're in the Discord or in anyone's Discord, they're posting screenshots of their chart. You're going to click this little camera button here. And this will give you an image URL that you can copy. And then you can go into anywhere you want. Like you could go into Discord and you could just come up in here to, let's see, where we're go to the Bitcoin section and just paste it in here. And all of a sudden, we have this chart in the Discord that other people can see. Okay. And of course, nobody knows why I posted this in here. And it's probably going to get some weird discussion. But that's how you would do that. And let me think. Is there anything else here? Yes. Price action. Let's talk about price action. Okay. What are candlesticks? This is very important. Candlesticks. These things on the screen here are candlesticks. And I'm going to have to remove that watermark because I just can't take it. These green and red things are candlesticks. And there's a lot of information packed in to a candlestick. The candlestick will tell you three things, well, technically four things. It will tell you the open, the close, the high, and the low of each candle. Now, depending on what time frame you're on, that candle will represent that price action in that specific period of time. So if we're on a 1 minute time frame, each candle represents 1 minute of price movement. If we're on a 5 minute time frame, each candle represents 5 minutes of price movement. If we're on a 9 minute time frame, each candle represents 9 minutes of price action. And the candle will tell you a number of things. For a green candle or an upward moving candle, depending on what color you're using, It will tell you the bottom of the candle body, okay? The big shaded area, that's known as the body, and then the lines on the tops are known as wicks, right? Because they're candlesticks. Candles have wicks and bodies. The top of the candle let's draw it out here. Okay, if we have a candle, this is our candle here. Okay, it's a red candle. The red candle, or the downward moving candle, the top of the body is the open price of that candle. So right here, this candle for Ethereum USD opened at $2,678. Okay, we put a horizontal line right at the top of this candle. You can see it's $2,678. The bottom of the body tells you the closing price of that candle. The closing price of this candle right here, this one that I am clicking right here, okay, closed at $2,661.08. Now, the wicks of the candle will tell you the high and the low during that candle. Okay, so if you hear somebody say we wicked up to somewhere, you hear TA guys say, you know, I entered short right here. You know, I entered a short position right here, but I got wicked out. I got wicked out of that trade. Well, what they're saying is they saw that we were coming down and they decided to enter short, and they entered short right here. But then this candle wick came up and took them out of their trade. They got stopped out of their trade. They got wicked out of their trade. And then, you know, they're like, dang, I got wicked out of that trade. Well, they should have put their stop loss above the last swing high, but we'll get into that later. Or if you hear people say we wicked up to that resistance, or we wicked down to that support, you know, that's what we're talking about. Support and resistance, we'll get into that in the next session. They're basically just horizontal lines on your chart. If you see a candle and it comes down below a level and then comes back up, that's called wicking down, and vice versa. If it comes up and then comes back down, that's called wicking up. So for the downward candles, we have the open at the top of the candle, the close at the bottom of the candle, and then the wicks are the high and the low. And for the green or the upward moving candles, the bottom of the body is the open price. So for this candle right here, we opened up at about 2,659.39. The top of the body is the close price. We closed the candle at 2,672. It's called opening and closing of the candle because once this candle is done, we call that closing, and then this second candle opens. And before a candle closes, we say it's printing. Okay, you'll say it's printing because it's a chart. Right, and back in the day, all charts were on paper, and so this candle is currently printing on the chart, and it's not confirmed until it closes. And that's a good keyword lingo to know. If you hear people saying it's confirmed, this candle confirmed, they mean it closed. Before the candle closes, it's unconfirmed, right? Because this green candle is not a green candle until it closes. How do we know it's not going to wick up and then turn down into a red candle? As these candles are printing, they could change color, right? This red candle probably started out as a green candle as it came up here. Because remember, the candle opened right here. This is the open of the candle at the top of this body. It probably started out as a green candle coming up. And then what happened is we wicked down. And then once we came below the open price, we turned into a red candle. So it's unconfirmed until we, let's see what's happening with Bitcoin over here. Wow, look at this. Look at this, getting a little pump. Going to Pump City over here, guys. Well, I have to stick to the course, so I'm not going to look at the Bitcoin price action, but I wonder how my trades are doing. Looks like my Bitcoin short is in less profit than it was. Looks like I'm losing money rapidly over here. And just so everybody knows, I this is already a guaranteed winning trade because I've locked in the profits. We'll get into that more later in the course. Yes, so that's confirming candles. Those are what Japanese candles are. There's other candles called Heiken Ishii candles. If you're familiar with CryptoFace and MarketCypher, you know he uses the Heiken Ishii candles. These are different than standard Japanese candlesticks because they're basically giving you an average. Right, they're giving you an average of the price. It's not the actual price. They're good for helping you see trends. You can see how easy it looks to buy the low and sell the high when we have Heiken Ishii candles, right? Compared to regular candles. Look, you know, it's like they're sloppier looking when they're regular as compared to Heiken Ishii. This is a personal preference thing. In this course, I'm going to be using primarily regular candles because that's how I learned technical analysis. That's what I prefer. You can use whatever you want. This is 100% a personal preference, okay? Now, let's talk about the candlestick cheat sheet because there's a lot of things that you can use. There's a lot of things that you can see just by looking at candlesticks. And this picture should be linked on the website. And these are candlestick patterns, okay? There's a lot of things you can see just by looking at a candle. There's bullish patterns, there's neutral patterns, and there's bearish patterns, okay? Now, what I want you to do is I want you to study this candlestick cheat sheet because these candle patterns will help you identify trend reversals or trend continuations. Some things you need to get familiar with, a doji. A doji is a candle with a very tiny body and big wicks up and down. And let's see actually if we had a really nice doji actually today. I don't know if it's still a doji. No, it's not a doji anymore. But here's a good example of a doji right here. This candle right here is a doji. We have a long wick to the upside, a long wick to the downside, and a tiny little body. Dojis are neutral candles. They are showing indecision, meaning the market can't decide if it wants to go up or down. Just something to know. Then we have something like this. A dragonfly doji usually represents the bottom of a downtrend because think about it. We were in a downtrend. The sellers tried to keep pushing it down, but then the buyers bought it back up. And, you know, they took control of the market, right? Sellers are pushing it down. The buyers are like, oh, no, you don't. They buy it up. And from that point on, we continue with the uptrend. Okay? Then we have the opposite of that, a shooting star. A shooting star or a gravestone doji. These are all variations of the same thing, by the way. You know, we have shooting stars, gravestone dojis. Shooting stars are basically, let's see if I can find one here. You know, the candlestick cheat sheet shows you that shooting star. Maybe if we go to a lower time frame, we'll be able to find one. This is a shooting star right here. It symbolizes usually that we're going to come down, right? It's called a shooting star because we have the trail of the star, and then we have the actual star part. And you can know that the shooting star is a bearish candlestick pattern because shooting stars come down, right? And usually that means we're going to come down. It's because the buyers tried to push it up, and the buyers tried to push it up. The sellers were like, no, you don't, and they took it down. Familiarize yourself with these candlestick patterns, okay? Marubozo, these are these huge candles that have no wicks, okay? Some of the most important ones to remember are these bullish and bearish patterns right here. The hanging man, shooting star, gravestone doji, hammer, inverted hammer, dragonfly doji. These are good ones to memorize and familiarize yourself with because they will help you in making trading decisions. We have two candle patterns here. We have three candle patterns. Memorize these. I don't focus too much on the candlestick patterns in this course. It's important to know in the back of your mind as a reference so you can say, look, that candle looks bullish or bearish. But in general, I will focus more on other things, but really familiarize yourself with this, memorize this chart. Okay, so let's talk about identifying trends because this is very important. There's three types of trends you will find when you're trading. We have uptrends, downtrends, and sideways trends. Okay, uptrends, downtrends, and sideways trends. So if we come to our Bitcoin chart here, our trusty old Bitcoin chart, okay, it's trusty, all right. You'll notice that we have different types of trends, right? We have an uptrend. This is where clearly price is moving up and we're making higher lows and higher highs on the chart, okay? What I mean by higher lows and higher highs is we have a low right here. This is the low, also known as the swing low. That's important to know. When you're looking at the chart, price isn't just going to move up and down like this, right? It's going to come down and then retrace a little, then down and retrace a little, then down and retrace a little. And the opposite is true on the way up. It's going to come up and retrace, up and retrace, up and retrace, up and retrace. And just so you know, a retracement, and we're going to get into this later, is moving in the opposite direction of the trend. The trend is the main direction with these big long legs, these big long moves, and then a retracement is moving a little bit in the opposite direction. This is how price moves. A swing low is the tip. A swing high is the tip. Okay? It's important to know those terms, swing low and swing high. So right here, if we're analyzing this piece of price action on the chart, this would be a swing low. Okay, this would be a swing high, this would be a swing low. Potentially this could be a swing high, but I would honestly say that this would be our swing high here. It's the highest point before we get the reversal. And then this right down here would be our swing low. Okay, that's how you are going to identify swing lows and swing highs. And so if we are in an uptrend, we are consistently going to be making higher highs and higher lows, okay? You hear people talking about higher highs and higher lows. That's because, look, we come down to the swing low, and we make a high and a low and then a higher high and then a higher low than this previous low and then a higher high and then a higher low than that previous low, then a higher high, then a higher low, then a higher high, then a higher low, then a higher high, then a higher low, then a higher high, then a lower low. And then a lower high, and then a lower low, and then a lower high, and then a lower low. This is how we're going to determine whether it's an uptrend or a downtrend. Uptrends are consistently making higher highs and higher lows. That's the definition of an uptrend. Higher highs, higher lows. Definition of a downtrend is lower lows and lower highs. Now, we wouldn't know at this point that the uptrend was over. We wouldn't know that until down here where we put in a lower low. And really, if we just draw a horizontal line here, this is actually not a lower low. This is the same exact low that we put in the first time. So this is called a head and shoulders pattern, which we will get into later in the course. But a head and shoulders pattern is a bearish pattern, which usually means we are going to break down out of that pattern, okay? So we really wouldn't know for certain that we were in a downtrend until we print that lower low down here. So it's not always as easy to find those tops and bottoms. You know, most of our trades are going to be, we'll get into that later. So an uptrend, you'll be able to identify uptrends by the higher highs and higher lows. I want you to go to a chart right now, any time frame, okay? Any time frame. And I want you to identify uptrends like this, and I want you to identify downtrends, just circle them, okay? And then there is something called a ranging market, okay? A ranging market. A ranging market is where price doesn't really have an up or a downtrend, but it kind of moves sideways. We're going to be talking about this a lot in the course. Sideways markets, okay? Sideways markets. We kind of have that right here too. We had that back in January right here where Bitcoin was ranging in a sideways market. Plenty of opportunity to trade, but it's clearly not an up or downtrend, right? It's clearly not an up or downtrend right here. Before we broke out of 20K, we were ranging for a while. Down here, look at this, trading sideways, just ranging for quite some time. Ranging for quite some time. It's very important that we learn how to trade in these ranging markets because anyone can trade in a bull market and just long the dip. But if you keep trying to long the dip down here, let me tell you, you're going to get sliced up with Edward Scissorhand type scissors. Okay? You need to make sure that you are able to identify your environment. Is it an uptrend? Is it a downtrend? Is it a sideways market? That will determine how you trade. Okay? I'm sorry that I have these lines on the chart, guys, but it is what it is. I'm unashamed of my purple and blue. And black. Purple and blue and black. Okay. Go ahead now. Hike and a she makes it very easy to identify the trend. Okay. Because hike and a she will just show you trends like that. And then the sideways trends characterized by very small changes like that. Go ahead and just learn uptrend, downtrend, sideways market, because that's important. All right, guys, that wraps it up for session numero uno, which is Spanish for session number one. Unless anyone thinks I'm waxing politically incorrect, let me just inform you that I am 25% Spanish, literally Spanish, from Spain, okay? So I hope you enjoyed this session, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.
Thank you.
sounds that are going on around you. Just listen to the general hum and buzz of the world as if you were listening to music. Don't try to identify the sounds you are hearing. Don't put names on them. Simply allow them to play with your eardrum. Don't judge the sounds. There are no, as it were, proper sounds or improper sounds. It's all just sound. As you hear sounds coming up in your head, you simply listen to them as part of the general noise going on, and soon you will find that the so-called outside world and the so-called inside world come together, come together, come together, come together. I want you to listen to the sound of my voice just as if it were noise. Don't try to make any sense out of what I'm saying, because your brain will take care of that automatically. You don't have to try to understand anything. Just listen to the sound. As you hear sounds coming up in your head, you simply listen to them as part of the general noise going on, and soon you will find that the so-called outside world and the so-called inside world come together. Come together. Come together. Come together. Come together. They are a happening, and everything is simply a happening. All you're doing
is watching it.